Welcome to Statics.
Example: Analysis of Machines. In this example, we have the bucket control mechanism of a front-end loader. We want to find the forces in the hydraulic rams DC and DE. The section on the left is the support that represents the rest of the vehicle. We won't be using it for anything, but we see that the rest of the machine is attached to it by pins at points A and B. Note that the hydraulic ram BC is a two-force member. So the support can be represented as three forces acting on the rest of the machine, two at A and one at C. We can group all the members into one free body diagram and solve for all three forces, which includes the force in ram BC. Here is free body diagram 1, with one known force and three unknown forces. By summing moments at A, I can solve for the force in the two-force member BC. I get negative 12.31 kips, or 12.31 kips in compression, and that is one of the two hydraulic ram forces I am looking for. I don't need the reaction forces at A to finish this problem, but I will get them anyway by summing forces in the x direction and in the y direction. I show my updated reaction forces on the machine. The next thing I want to do is look for other two-force members in my machine. There are three more, DE, EF, and EG. I don't know the forces in any of them right now, but if I can get EF or EG, I can use the method of joints to get the force in ram DE. My next step, then, is to analyze a free body diagram of one of the members. The bucket will be the best choice because it has one known force acting on it and only three unknowns, since member EG is a two-force member. I can solve for all the unknowns. I will first sum moments about point H to get force EG. The easiest way to handle the angle of force EG is to divide the force into horizontal and vertical components. My moment equation then has the horizontal component, FEG, times the sine of 100 degrees minus 90 degrees, which is 10 degrees, times its moment arm, 4.1 feet. It is positive by the right-hand rule. I also include the vertical component of force EG, which is FEG, times the cosine of 10 degrees, times its moment arm, 2 feet. It is also positive, minus the applied force times its moment arm, 3.5 feet, all equal to zero. I get that force EG is positive 5.22 kips. So the two-force member is in tension, as shown in my free body diagram. I don't need the reaction forces at H to finish this problem, but I will get them anyway by summing forces in the X direction and by summing forces in the Y direction. Now that I know the force in member EG, I can use the method of joints to get the force in ram DE. Free body diagram 3 represents the joint at E. I will get the two unknown forces by summing forces in the X and Y directions. Summing forces in the X direction, I get an equation with both unknowns. Summing forces in the Y direction, I get another equation with the same two unknowns. By solving the two equations simultaneously, I get that the force in hydraulic ram DE is 6.36 kips in tension. And now I have my second answer. The force in member EF is negative 6.71 kips, or 6.71 kips in compression. We now have the forces in both rams, and the problem is complete. Note that along the way, we found all of the forces acting on the arm member. We did not need a free body diagram of this member to solve the problem, but we can use it now to check our answers. This is a good thing to do when you need to know your work is correct. If I sum forces on free body diagram 4 in the X direction, they sum to zero. That is a good sign. If they did not equal zero, I would know I have one or more errors. When I sum forces in the Y direction, they also sum to zero. Now I'm feeling really good about my answers. I'm trying